Oh, I did work it right. God, I just did it well before. But anyway, I've been throwing off things. I have a brain injury in 4/19/02, so it was in April. It's 15 years later, right? 42, okay, 14 years later. 15, but anyway, reason I'm doing this is because I wrote a lot of stuff down, but having a brain injury, people don't understand. I know my eyes are different, so duh, that, because that happened too. Because of, and I don't remember what I was going to say because I did that. I'm sorry. I'm doing this because brain injury people or guardians, family members try to do their damnedest to help. And so I'm going to explain the things that happened to me. I couldn't make a full sentence. I couldn't even understand what people said. So almost 15 years later, 14 years later, I'll explain. I'm going to throw it out there because this is how I speak. I'm from Minnesota, and I was driving through Chaska. I don't remember why, but I was lost, which then it wasn't bad, so or normal. But anyway, so I was lost. So I went around for like an hour trying to figure out how to get out of there. I won't forget that part. And then I was in a cul-de-sac, and I kept going around, and I seen these people sitting out and talking to people. It was a weekend, and I'm like, oh shoot, I can't keep doing that. So I started humming. I went, is not a song. It wasn't anything. And then I caught myself because I don't know if people realize you have a brain and you have, what was the word? A brain and a mind. Okay. So when I did that, I started humming and I'm like, I turned really calm. And then my mind or my brain was saying, why are you humming? And I that was my thought, but I kept humming through the whole thing until I found my way out. And I was very calm. And you have to remember, I hummed, and I didn't know why I was doing it. So if you see some people humming, or a brain injury person or anything, humming, it's almost like either I don't want to hear you, which I don't know if I did that. I don't think so. Or I was lost, and I was really lost in my head that I did that. So I got home. There are other things that I did. I think I'm going to mention it afterwards. A video I just did. I was right in the middle of everything explaining it. So anyway, I'm sorry. But I've always been this way, I think. But the other one is that, and I totally forgot. Hold a second. Brain injury. Oh, I was with my mom and dad, and I'm going to use this part because this was really meaningful for other brain injury people that either had born with a brain injury, had drugs and got a brain injury, had a seizure and had a brain injury, or me had a car accident and had a brain injury. Okay, I just thought of it. Okay, I'll explain what happened to me. I was right by my house in Eden Prairie, and I was driving home to my house. I'm getting gas from a normal, you know, gas station. And so I was driving a green light. This Tahoe went from one side across the highway. They had a red light. I had a green light. And from, I think it's a tenth of a second. I could be wrong. But I was driving and then, boom, I swung around. And I remember I was out. But then a little redhead came up later, so I hope you guys can catch my drift here. A little redhead came out from McDonald's and said, I've seen everything that happened. It's, you know, it's his fault. And then the guy who hit me was there too. But, and stopping at that part because I'll have more. But going in, he asked me, the guy who hit me, asked me to go into this parking lot. And I was like waking up and I heard him and he goes, can you open the door? And I pushed the button down. And I'm like, it doesn't work. I totally remember that. And then straight in front of me, there was this man, blondish brown hair. He lifted up his phone. And I'm like, then I grabbed mine and I lifted it. And he like, okay. So then I knew that he, I don't know if he called, I didn't. But he called or anybody called that for the accident. So he nodded his head And then he went on. And I still, I don't know if I'd remember him, but I know that it was really sweet. So then I moved over. I can only go one way. One way down. And so I stopped. And I didn't know what happened. I just knew I got hit. And, okay, I'm going to keep going. So when he hit me, I just seen him like, crap, and he hit me. What's really funny is that I went out. I don't feel it that he hit me. I just knew that my elbow and my head hit the window. And then, you know, if you're older and you guys had pop, soda pop years ago, the cans were really hot, much stronger than what they are now. And that's what I heard when the truck was hitting the car. It was this really long, you know, I'm going to say 3 foot, the way I felt it was in my head. It was a 3 foot crushing of a can, like, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. And that's what I remember. I had, my jaw was dislocated, my elbow more than bruised because it took me for years to get it to work. I couldn't lift my hands up in my head. And I was out until I faced the other way, and I heard the guy in the little redhead say something. Then the police came, and they said what happened, and I didn't pay attention. I wasn't really listening because they were in the end over there. And this van came up from McDonald's and said, "Are you okay? Are you okay?" He's fleeing the scene. He's fleeing the scene. And the guy, when I pulled over, he said, "I have to go to the bathroom." And that's why he went across the highway. He had to go pee so bad. And he was 67 years old. And I looked at the lady. He goes, no, he's not leaving. He has to go to the bathroom. If you need anything, girlfriend, you let me know. And I'm like, okay, thank you. And then the cop comes to look at my car. He was on one side, and he goes, "What happened?" And when I got out of the car, I couldn't get out of the driver's side. So I went across to the passenger side, got out, and I said, "I don't know." And I looked at my car on the left side. He hurt my car. It's so funny. But that was funny. He goes, "Okay, are you okay?" Whatever. They brought an ambulance over. And I'm kind of independent that I'm like, "I'm okay. I'm fine. My arm is just shaking, like, yeah, whatever." And, okay. I wasn't going to bring this up, but I have to. It worked so well with everything I had. I was married. At that time, I was married. And I called him up, and I really didn't, but I didn't want to, but I called him up, and I said, "Come here by, you know, McDonald's in the area on Dakota Avenue." And he did. And he goes, "What?" Well, I won't say the words he said, but he goes, "What the hell did you do?" Me, as usual, he blames everything on me. And I said, "Look at my car here. Why? Why'd you do that?" So then I had to go into the ambulance. They're checking me out. "Are you okay?" "Mm-hmm." "Are you fine?" "Mm-hmm." "We want to take it to the hospital to make sure you're okay." And I'm like, no. And my husband says, "Get your ass in there because, you know, you don't know what's wrong with you. And, you know, I don't want to be helping you later." Okay. Now that was an interesting one. So then I went home. I had to take my car to my house, which was, 2 blocks away from there. We went to the side roads, and the policeman said, "Let's just take her," because I'm like, "I'm not leaving my car. I'm not leaving my car." And so he goes, "Just follow me." And he told my husband just to go up front and he'll follow me, whatever. So I did, dropped it off. Jumping from another end, I had to have a garage sale before that, so I had plans. So I'm out there. I had braces on my arms and my legs and stuff. And the girl said, "I seen this car." And I'm like, "Yeah." She says, "That was over there on Dakota." I'm like, "Yeah." She goes, "Oh my God, you're alive." It was the cutest thing because she gave me a hug, and I'm like, "What?" I go, "That was really sweet." And people who didn't see it just go, you know, "That was really good. But this is so sweet from her to do that. I wasn't going to do this." Okay. Whew. So then, okay, that was like a week later for my garage sale. So then when I went home, driving my car home, I put it in the garage, or put it outside, and some people came over. Okay, I'm jumping again. Well, okay, I'll use this part. Some people came over. "Can I show my kids your car?" From people who don't pay attention to driving. And I said, "Anything you want, go for it." So that was a different one. So I got home, And I ended up watching TV. Okay, my husband was a drunk. Continuous, I mean, horrible drunk, but I loved him at once. So he was downstairs with a friend he called his other dad. Phil, I can't think of it. Okay, I'm sorry. Phil, but he's a decorated somebody, which is incredible. He's a wonderful, wonderful man. So I yelled at him downstairs about, like, I think it was an hour later. And I yelled at him, nothing. He wouldn't care anyway. And then I finally, will you get up here? And he goes, what the F do you want? I said, I can't move. And he said, and you were supposed to go to the ER. Why do I have to take you now? And I couldn't get out of the chair, which was really weird. And then went to the ER. I can't remember where it was. I can see it. But he just says, now we're going to have to be here forever because you wouldn't listen and whatever. So then they did some stuff. And I was okay. I was just a little bit shocked, basically. Otherwise, I was pretty okay. I'm going to stop this because I'm going to do more. And this will be at the hospital. And it, okay, oh God, I don't want to quit, but I want to do it. I was fine, but I knew something was wrong with me, but I didn't know. So then I went home, and so people says, how long were you out? I said, the only time I was out was when I got hit, and I faced the other way, and the gentleman in the cute little redhead said, are you okay? Are you okay? And then he said, I seen what happened, and stuff like that. So, okay, I'm done with this one. I hope I'm not being a pain, but I'm going to do it anyway because I want people to understand this.